Mr. Payne, you've said a couple of times that deliberate online falsehoods are new. Deliberate falsehoods are as old as history. Would you agree?
Yeah, I said deliberate online falsehoods.
What is different today is that a very small number of internet giants control platforms through which a lot of communications take place. They are, as it were, the infrastructure. And within that infrastructure, flow of information, there is a lot of doffs, there is a lot of hate speech from our perspective, and there is a lot of things going on which seek to divide societies, undermine societies. Would you accept that?
Yes.
Thank you. Now, we've heard a lot of broad statements from all of you, and I'm sure you mean it, every word of it, on how you're improving all the time, how you're incredibly proactive, how serious you are about it, and we welcome that. What gives maybe a little bit of pause is what we see on the record, the types of cases, illustrations I've taken you through, others have taken you through, what the UK Parliament has gone through, what has been gone through with the US Congress. Whenever it comes to specifics, then we look at the specific areas, specific points, and the answers don't seem quite satisfactory. I'm not asking you to comment. I'm just giving you a perspective. Let me give you just one illustration because it's been a long day. I'll show you a cartoon right now, which was on Twitter. This was a cartoon on Twitter. This was the subject of a question in the UK Parliament to Twitter. Twitter refused to take this down. And the reason it refused to take it down is that this was not in breach of Twitter's hateful conduct policy. If this is not in breach of a hateful conduct policy, I find it difficult to understand what else can be. So the various beautiful statements you make, Mr. Payne, and others, have to be tested against the reality. As it is, this is where the rubber hits the road. And for us in Singapore, this is way beyond what we will tolerate. And I'm not even sure that this may come within the policy of the other platforms here to take down. So that is just to put a perspective that while we listen to a lot of statements, we have to get back to what you actually do. I've made that point a number of times to Mr. Milner as to why I wanted to look at what was said in the US Congress, why I wanted to see what was said in the UK Parliament. These are the reasons. So for us as a multiracial society, where we are very strict about what is said, putting up something like this about Muslims will be completely unacceptable as a matter of law. And if the law does not cover this, then we will have to have law that covers this. And no amount of protestation that self-regulation will be enough is going to wash. This is not much of a question. It is more to give you my perspective. But if you have a viewpoint, either yourself or Twitter, you are welcome to respond. But I was quite shocked to read in the transcript the response that this does not contravene our takedown policy on hate speech. This is why the Facebook executive Chakraborty talks about social media at its worst corrodes democracy. When you have this, how do you have a proper debate between two sides on immigration, for example, because this is guttural. It aims at your gut. Facts and logic matter no longer. And it's very difficult for social media companies then to portray themselves as champions of free speech. This has got nothing to do with free speech. Thank you. Do you want to answer on behalf of Twitter?
I'm unfamiliar with the specifics of this particular case or posting, but I just wanted to clarify, which UK testimony were you referring to, Minister? Sorry.
Notes, I'll give it to you. This was question number 438 I think it was given either in the Select Committee hearing in February or the Home Affairs Committee meeting in last year. I will get that. Sorry, it is now there, flashed up. Question 438. And it contained a hashtag, deport all Muslims, with a very disturbing graphic cartoon that's clearly designed to alarm and distress. It does not breach our community standards. And you look at the answer. So we have to come back to the reality beyond broad statements. That was the answer given in the United Kingdom. And I'm not even sure, as I said, that any of the other platforms will say this breaches their standards. I don't know. Based on the answers given today, I don't know. So thank you very much.
Okay, as there are no further questions, I would like to thank all the witnesses very much for the long hours they have spent here with us. Okay, we will be sending you a transcript of today's events. If there are any inaccuracies or if they need minor amendments, please do the corrections and return the transcript to us. Once again, thank you very much.
For the record, it was the Home Affairs Committee in March 2017. Thank you.